Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Age 2, where today we're gonna do Sebastian's personal mission, even though he was the first one we got, and he's gonna be the last one we do! Yay! Oh, I don't know. I'll bring Anders. Anders hasn't spoken to Sebastian. High town it is. Oh, I did give him, I leveled him up, gave him some points, put most of his points into dexterity. One into constitution, or one or two, and then one into cunning. So now he's a level 20 cunning, so. So he can open standard chests. Oh, friggin' heck. Let's give him a decent bow. Good golly. And yes, you get that. Even though I know there are probably others that are better, but it has your name on it, so you get it. Also, I did want to give the Ravani Seer to her. I don't know what's up with the plus 4 physical damage, like 4%. It's not a big deal. Wait, okay. You have a belt. You need rings. Sure, have that one. And we're selling that, so no, you don't want that one. Oh, well, I get... Yeah, he could have used this, whatever, I guess. Doesn't matter. Putting that in storage. Do we have a better... Boy, I should go through my... Dang it! Oh, freaking keep forgetting. Hubris, that's pride. Wow. Oh, boy. I don't really like the mana regeneration stuff. Lyrium imbued etched staff. That's really cool. Fire damage. Jeez. 14% fire damage, 28 spirit damage. 14. It's the same thing. Bow. Freaking bow, man. Okay. Ooh. Oh, his bow's name is Temperance. That's cool. Time to toss it. And that one. Excellent! We can finally start tossing those. Okay, this one's only got 2 stars. That one's only got 3 stars. These are, like, not the same, but they got the same name. Honeycut. What are the ones you have on right now? Okay, get rid of that one, I guess. What? Did you get rid of both of them? Well, okay, that's 25, 28, 43 physical damage. Sure. Wait, she gotta have 2 daggers. Right. Oh, is that a... That's not a sword. Oh my gosh, is it a sword? No, it's not. Why can't... Hold on. Am I doing this wrong? What am I doing? Oh, freaking... I hate it when it does that. Yes, that one. You retard. Okay. Well... I guess I'll... Toss those and that and that. Maybe keep those ones. I have so many staves. I'm like, freaking, I don't know.
Buy armor today.
Okay. That's about half as much space. Oh, I guess. Oh, I should, I should go through that stuff, I guess. Jeez. It's only got one, though. Oh well. Won't worry about it for now.
I notice you talk about vulgar things quite a bit.
Do you want me to stop? Do I make you uncomfortable?
It was just an observation, really.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a bad habit I picked up, spending years with foul-mouthed pirates. Pirates only care about a small number of very specific things.
Small number?
The sea, strong drink, and booty. Both kinds.
I read in his thing that he used to be a womanizer, though, so I feel like he would, I don't know, get pulled back into his ways or something. Or understand or something. I don't know. He was not in the Chantry. Not in the Chantry his whole life. That's why I guess he got sent to the Chantry, because his parents were embarrassed about all his womanizing and stuff. And that's basically the only reason. What am I doing? The only reason he's alive. I don't know why I was like going to that arrow. I don't know. Is this the correct way? Yes. So many guards out. You ready? You ready? I feel like I maybe should have brought Varric. He probably would have had funny things to say. We are going to talk to nobles. I'll save. Well, yeah, no, I'll save. And in we go! There's a couple things that I really do want to go back and check out, but it's, I also really want to keep playing. Dang it, I meant to go talk to Gamlin first! Gah! And this is gonna be long, isn't it?
The door's wide open. And not a single guard posted. This is not the Lady Harriman I remember. There is something very wrong
in
here.
It's way too quiet. Okay. Nope. The doors are open the way I'm... Bottles of wine.
More, you lazy son of a bitch! What's taking so long?
Is she drunk? She's Flora? Out of her mind?
Why does no one in this house care what I want? More wine, or I swear I will drown you in the dregs.
She doesn't even see us. This is no normal wine.
Are you sure? Is she like a... Who is she?
Anything interesting happening around town?
I don't know what this is. She looks too nicely dressed to... Oh my gosh.
More locks. It must be molten. You, more coins. I want every scrap of gold in this house.
What?
Please, monsieur!
There's nothing to fear. You'll be beautiful.
Are you gonna try and dip her
Pour
in
it
gold?
Over her.
Don't! You'll kill her! He can't hear me.
Why did he just walk over to us?
Perhaps I should be the one.
Oh,
we must
shoot.
End this madness.
What is... What's going on here?
I have prayed for Andraste to guide us to peace with the Harrimans.
What's going on here? Oh, hey, you got some stuff. There you go, good for you. Okay, was there... This was the hallway we came.
Oh, mother.
I need more. There shall never be enough.
Ow. Oh. First day of harvest, Mary. Mother finally began her expansion to the estate today. She brought in 2 dozen men from the Imperium, who I'm sure were slaves, and they've been excavating the hillside behind the house. The dirt is awful, and the noise must they shatter every rock in Kirkwall? It's been quiet since lunch, though, and Mother is behaving very strangely. She's now talking about stopping the expansion just like that, with no explanation. She never tells me anything. Oh, that's the girl downstairs. And her mother is Lady Harriman? Huh. Well, we haven't been attacked.
I visited this house often as a child. They could not have concealed such goings-ons.
What goings-ons? What? What? I don't know what we're doing. Oh, that's where I'm supposed to go. Whoa, no. Did I say we haven't been attacked yet? Before the Vales came to power, Starkhaven was ruled in quick succession by a number of petty warlords. Some were genuine bannermen, but others were little more than bandits. Tired of the constant petty raiding and warfare between Starkhaven and neighboring cities, the original Lord Vale organized a peaceful protest against King Ironfist, the low-born, self-declared king of Starkhaven. Hundreds of Starkhaven's most prominent citizens fasted for 10 days and nights on the steps of the Chantry, their numbers increasing every day. When the soldiers began deserting in droves at this example of piety, Iron Fist surrendered his sword to the Templars and left Starkhaven forever. In gratitude, the people of Starkhaven demanded that Lord Vale be king. He refused, however, saying that he had no right to that title. He was instead proclaimed the Prince of Starkhaven, and his family has ruled there ever since. They remained devout, dedicating at least one son or daughter per generation to become a cleric in the Chantry. Okay, so, Prince is basically the same thing as a king, guy. You have the same powers as a king, you just don't want the title. Ah! Oh,
lower.
Oh my gosh!
Lower.
Oh my gosh!
I beg your pardon, Hawk. I did not mean to expose you.
This time I just see Isabella's face!
No apologies necessary.
No. The feather.
Did you see Isabella's face?
Use the feather.
And Anders, too.
Where have you been all my life?
What?
Today, I am more than a man.
Is she crazy?
Come, felicitate me.
That's a great line. I should use that.
No, don't ever.
Ooh, I could get it embroidered on my blouse.
Oh my gosh!
He has no idea we're here. I've known Ruxton Harriman my whole life. He's a complete prude.
That's my kind of prude.
Where's your brother? Let's ask him to join us.
Is she crazy too, or what?
You know what they say about a man.
Yeah? Why is Flora's diary? Are you in Flora's room, or what? The 11th day, what can be happening? First father, now Brett. I can't talk to either of them anymore. I don't know what they're drinking, but they are lost in their own little worlds, and Mother doesn't care. Should she even be here? All she talks about is Starkhaven and marrying me off to that idiot Goran Vale. What madness has come over this place? But she was the one we found drinking.
You know what they say.
Oh, shoot. I don't think. Nope, neither of you can do a complex chest. Oh, well.
I have the manacles right here.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. So they're all doing the opposite? Like, I bet you Flora wouldn't. She doesn't drink normally or something, you know? And that guy was probably like, really austere or whatever, you know? Like, they didn't care much for money. Whoop. Sebastian, where'd you go? Okay. Gee! Hello? Uh-oh. Oh! Flint Company Mercenary. That must be the one that I was missing.
Turn back. There is nothing here for you.
What?
Odd. When we watched you being a drunken ass, you ignored us completely.
You shall not enter.
Are these siblings? Oh boy, are they possessed? Anders! I smack you. Come on. Oh, no. Shouldn't have brought Isabella. Oh, my gosh. Get off us. Fade's Fury.
When a plan works out.
Demon. Temptresses.
Yep.
We must see what greater evil they were protecting.
Okie dokie then. Well, how about it? How about that? I think I have a present for you, Sebastian. I don't know. I haven't gotten any approval or disapproval from him, I don't think. So, would the gift automatically go friendship? I don't know him well enough to give him gifts. Oh my gosh! This reminds me of...
So close to Hightown. I remember no such thing.
Shoot, why don't I have freaking... Varric or Meryl with me? Fenris! Fenris would have been good to bring on this one! These look like Tevinter ruins. In the shadows, is that what you're saying? Oh, they're back there too. The rage demon. Oh, he's popping up. He's popping up.
Popping up. Oh, hi.
There we go. Gotcha. Gotta go help my mage and my archer. Oh, shoot. I don't have it yet. Give it to me. Give it to me. Give it to me. I'm hearing a sound that sounds like the level up sound when you pick an ability in Inquisition. You hear that? I just heard it again. Okie dokie. Okay. I hope I didn't miss Varric's gift. There's a stamina drop in the rubble. What kind of ruins are these? I mean, they could be elven. From Inquisition, anyway, all we found were a lot of death temples, is what it seemed like, anyway. Oh. Oh, okay. Well, this is a different kind of... Oh, no! Revenant! Revenant bad! Revenant bad! Oh, boy. Just keep not moving, Revenant. Just hold your horses there, being all dizzy. Perfect! This corpse is harder to defeat than you are. I had Isabella's help. You hear that? I heard it again. You're annoying. I mean, I know they spawn them in because they don't want to, like, totally overwhelm you and throw them all in at once. But it's still just... I mean, at least they can show the corpse is coming up out of the ground.
Place one enemy at a time.
One enemy at a time. Are you going to talk now? No? That seemed... relatively important. Or this way. We have not seen any ruins like this. Yay, trash! I love trash! Do you have anything to say?
In the shadows! More of them!
Yeah, you're seeing things.
Have you ever been out in the open ocean in a
Okay,
storm?
Quick.
It's the best feeling.
Okay, yeah, well, Isabella was talking, so I'm out to hear it. Line up, Anders! Lighten up. Oh, hello, autosave! A body? Uh-oh. Looks like a fresh body, not like a corpsey body, you know what I mean? What the heck is up with this? We are like... There's like an enclave of demons in here.
I'll deal with this.
I hope Sebastian's doing okay. I don't think... I did his tactics a little bit, didn't I? He at least takes a health potion, right? Oh my gosh, this guy's just cropping up everywhere. Corpse. Ethereal Soraria. Corpse. Pouch of pebbles. Okay, you're just a normal corpse. This is so long! And freaking, but... Were these ruins built into the rock like this, or... And what are... You don't usually get underground stuff like this unless it's dwarven, but I don't think this is dwarf. But there was Tevinter stuff underground, wasn't there? That was part of the Enigma stuff we were seeing. What's this? It's like a shrine, an ancient sacrificial shrine. Nope. It. With garbage. Broken gems. And all these creepy things hanging around. Oh, nope, dang it. Oh. Oh, hello! I wanna at least get a good look at the room before you attack me. Oh, it's the glyph of, that's the glyph of paralysis he's been using. I see. I did mess with his tactics a bit to have him use that now. I'm already here, man. I'm already... Oh, did he pull Anders or me? Oh, he's dead. Okay, his corpse is now. I'm so glad there's not... Here, I'll let you take care of him. Oh my gosh. You are crazy. Okay, we've encountered like 2 revenants and like 2... Eh? Before the first blight, there lived an old man and a woman. One day, a beautiful stranger came to their house seeking shelter. The old man and woman gave her food to eat and a downy mattress to sleep upon. In return, she offered them a golden mirror that would grant 3 wishes. Looking into the mirror, the woman frowned at her wrinkles and gray hair. "I wish I were young again," she said. Suddenly, the face of a lovely maiden stared back at her. The man angrily grabbed the mirror, saying, "You're so selfish. You could have given youth to us both. I wish you weren't so stupid." At once, the woman was brilliant beyond measure and saw that her husband had never loved her. He tolerated her only because her age and ignorance made his own seem less by comparison. Angry now, the old woman grabbed for the mirror. At the same time, they both said, "I hate you. I wish that you get exactly what you deserve." With that, they were both back together, both ugly and old, but now knowing exactly how much contempt they had for each other. Better late than never, I guess. Ah, I should have brought Varric, dang it. I doubt we can come back. Oh my gosh! I was like, what is this? This is like a waterfall of skeletons! It's just like the weirdest, flattest waterfall. It's like a mountain of them! I mean, I've seen piles of them like this, but it's like the powdered remains of skeletons. Oh my gosh. What kind of evil have they stumbled upon? Holy crap, we have never seen a place that's this bad, ever. Look at this. This is Tevinter. 1, 2, 3, 4, only 6 here. 7, 8, oh, no, that's okay. But... This looks like what I saw in the Awakening DLC, sort of. And it was old Tevinter magic stuff, like the towers activations and stuff. Oh, hello. Somebody's kneeling to somebody else down there.
You must give me more. Starkhaven will not submit.
I put that idiot Goran Vale into the prince's seat, but the other families won't heed him. I must marry him to Flora and solidify our hold. But I need more power.
I've given you much. Your desires run deep. You've already traded your husband and your children. What more can you offer?
Oh, God!
At the Blooming Rose, 50 silver's standard for a horse.
You'll hardly find my silver.
Who is this? Who are you? How did you get here?
Oh, Sebastian. That was some expressive face.
You were
face.
My mother's friend. How could you murder her?
Such an ugly word. I prefer remove the only obstacle between her and her dreams.
This was your idea.
I could create such desires if I wished. But it's far easier to nurture those that already exist.
Well, the other people, they avoided what they desired upstairs.
You and your friend both possess it, do you not? You both wish to rise.
Oh, I do like power.
Not if it meant selling out my family.
I wouldn't sell out my friends. And then it said family and friends.
Do not listen to her.
Oh, such a pious soul. Masking so much ambition. Are you so different from my lady? You yearn for the same lands, the same power.
I am the rightful heir. She is a usurper and murderer.
You swore to put aside worldly goods and ambitions, but they couldn't stop you from wanting them.
You'll be a good ruler. It doesn't matter what you do to get there.
Oh, boy.
I'm not acting from ambition. I only want what's best for my people.
For the people who'll adore you. All those smiles they used to save for you.
I wonder if I should just tell her to shut up.
Now you'll be the shining prince. All you have to do is kill anyone in your way.
Silence, temptress. Your whispers led our allies astray. You're the only one I must kill.
Whoa! Nice! Oh boy. Kill the temptress! Good, Andrew's paralyzed her. Allure! Her name is Allure. Whoa, I just tried to do a thing and got knocked over. Ah. Okay. Health staff down. Lady Harriman, time to kill you now. Good. Had knocked her off balance. I was hoping it would. Come on, Sebastian. Oh, okay. That's it.
Let us return to the chantry. I must pray for Lady Harriman.
You are unstoppable, guy. What in the world did they find down here, though? Like, what... What is this place? Is this Elven to Venter? So many skeletons, though. Jeez. We just ran through there, and we don't know anything else about the place.
Let us return to the chantry.
Sebastian. I am so, so sorry. It's such an inadequate word.
Her mother gave her soul to the demon.
When I think what Mother made us do. What those creatures made us do.
We were friends, Flora.
It was like a cloud came down on me. All I could feel or think was what the demon allowed.
Was your mother a mage? How did she fight this demon?
We've never had magic in our line. Perhaps that made Mother too confident. She thought she could deal with a demon and not fall prey to
it. That was stupid.
Right. It is demons who should be feared, not mages.
Those ruins there
were unearthed
when we expanded the house. Mother found the demon inside. I think she had signed her bargain before we even knew.
Did your mother order the attack on Sebastian's family?
She did. You know Mother, Sebastian. She was always jealous of your parents. The demon twisted that until it was all she could think of. She was determined to seize Starkhaven for herself.
Don't blame your mother. The Desire Demon made this happen.
I doubt many people will be so forgiving. If it takes every last coin my family owns, I will make reparations to everyone
we've
wronged.
She seems like a good woman.
Starting with you, Sebastian. We weren't the only ones vying for Starkhaven. If you face more opposition, you have my support.
It will not make up for what happened.
No, that's true.
I'll tell you when I need you.
So is she the oldest then?
Let us return to the Chantry. I must pray for Lady Soul.
I thought I was gonna boop us out. Apparently not. Let's see if we can find everybody again. Oh, door. Was that? That wasn't there before. Oh. Father's behaving so oddly today. He pinched my butt, just reaching around the table, and I can't imagine what would make him do such a thing. And to the servant girls as well. Some of the things he says would truly make a sailor blush. I told the maids to lock up the wine, but it hasn't made any difference so far. I'm going to the chantry tonight to pray for him. Okay. Divine Justinia. Were these doors open before? I must have missed it. Okay. And then go see if there's a doors. Now I'm suspicious of all the doors. Oh boy! That's oh god. Ah! he probably left out of shame. Nope, not a door. What an odd series of coincidences. Not a series of coincidences, but an odd series of events. Where are the... did the other two, like, die or something? Now I can only get out. How do I get out of here? This way. Opa. Well, you've got help for your war to take back Starkhaven, Sebastian. Because nobody else has been pledging support. I don't know if I showed you guys that, but I think I did. Nobody's helping him right now. I mean, Kirkwall's been dealing with the Kunari. They can't leave the city empty, you know? They can't commit forces because he...
All right. Let's just get this over with.
A duel?
No, the sermon. The finger wagging, the guilt trips.
A duel?
Telling me how an
unexamined
life isn't worth living.
I wasn't going to...
You weren't? You weren't going to tell me to comfort the needy and give freely of myself.
From what I hear, you already give yourself quite freely.
Ooh, boy. You got me there.
I think she enjoys, like... She enjoys sex, obviously. Not a bad thing. But I think she maybe doesn't do...
Let's go in and put out the eternal flame.
Oh, boy. I think she maybe doesn't do as much as people think she does. But I don't know. I think it might be kind of an image she... But I know... Nah, I mean, she does, so... But I don't know. I just think it's not as big a deal as...
I used to be like you, you know.
Look! Oh, there's a thing
you
here!
You used to be a woman.
No.
That explains a lot.
My family put me in the Chantry because I was giving them a bad name. It was the best thing that ever happened to me. I found peace. I found a purpose. Before I came here, I used to be out to all hours, drinking, boring. I didn't believe in anything.
I knew these two would talk a lot.
My own pleasure.
Why couldn't I have met you then?
I had hoped prayer might cleanse me of the desire demons touch. But I still hear her voice so clearly. I feel like I've bathed in filth that will never come off.
Wash behind the ears. Evil usually gets stuck there.
The demon didn't lie. I used to be bitterly jealous of my brother. I wanted to be prince. Now everything he had is mine. And he lies in ashes. I keep asking myself, do I want this because it's right? Or simply to have what I never thought I could?
Aren't you your parents' heir?
I'm the youngest son of three.
Yep.
My parents were rather traditional. They wanted the heir and the spear, and I was left in the cold. They put me in the Chantry to prevent my competing with my brothers.
You seem very dedicated to the Chantry. You were put there against your will?
At first. But it was the best thing that could have happened. I was a wild boy, a shame to my family. The Chantry made me a man.
Well, your parents kind of left you high and dry, you know?
When I wanted to rule, I would have been terrible at it. Now that I might be decent, I don't know if it's the right thing to do.
I think he should take back his land.
Don't let the demon make you doubt yourself.
In trying to retake Starkhaven, I have already brought death to so many. Could I ever do enough good as prince to justify that?
Real princes don't worry about who they step on their way to the top.
I know you've done great things in Kirkwall, Hawk. I imagine your methods haven't always been scrupulous. But you clearly do more good than harm. I just don't know if I can follow that road.
Rivalry, eh? I didn't really like that though. All right, we'll do it really quick. I don't know. I think I should do the down option.
There are still many refugees. You seem very angry.
And here I thought the Chantry was against mind-reading.
Did something happen to you in the Circle?
Ooh, don't ask that!
I understand there were problems in Ferelden.
Don't ask that!
Are you saying a mage can only be unhappy in the Circle if demons are involved? No. It's not about Aldred. It's not about being beaten or raped by a Templar. That does happen. But I've been fortunate. It's a larger principle. The freedom every man, woman, and child born in Thedas have as a natural right.
You were given to the Circle. I was given to the Chantry. Hawk was driven away from home by the Darkspawn. None of us are free.
Huh. That's a good point, Sebastian.
Do enough good as prince to justify that.
Would you stand aside and let someone else claim what your family fought and died for?
I know you've done great things in Kirkwall, Hawk. I imagine your methods have...
All right. Well, let's do this then.
I think this is yours.
My grandfather's bow.
I'm good at giving grandfather's bows out.
One of the Flint Company men did some looting. I figured I'd return the favor.
Thank you. It's hard to mourn the loss of a thing while my family lies dead. But I did think of it.
What's the story behind that, Beau?
As the youngest son, it was my place to lead Starkhaven's militia. But I never had a talent for swordplay. Too much getting hit.
Yeah, unpleasant.
My grandfather said the bow is the wise man's weapon. You can defend your city without opening its gates. Grandfather said the day I could pull the string on his bow, it would be mine.
Then why didn't you have it with you?
I was 13 when my grandfather made me that promise. I would rise at dawn to practice my shots until I could hit the isolate of a helmet from the top of the ramparts.
Whoa.
But my parents pledged me to the Chantry before I could show him.
Oh.
Were you and your grandfather close?
He was a man of the world. Prince of Starkhaven. But he had the most unshakable faith in the Maker. When my parents threatened to pledge me to the Chantry, he told me he'd gladly trade his title for a life of contemplation. The Maker ordained a place for each of us, I remember him saying. We have only to serve.
Oh, boy. I don't know. We'll try.
I'm sorry I never got a chance to meet them. To save them.
I know. You're a true friend, Hawk. You brought me this to remember and honor them. But if I could bring back our lowest servant by snapping it in half, I'd do it without regrets.
Oh boy, we're back at zero again. Gosh dang it. Gosh dang it. I don't know. I'm not gonna worry too much about Sebastian, I don't know. I don't want to be mean. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, I gotta go eat. I'm hungry. So we'll save it here and come back and see what I feel like. Anyway, thanks again for joining me. I'll see you in the next one.